Consider this simple equation. It's easy to see that the solution is x equals 1. Alternately, you can take everything to one side and call it y, then plot the graph of y versus x and see where y equals 0. We can see that that happens when x equals 1. As the relationship between y and x becomes more and more complex, it becomes harder to find an x where y equals 0.
Let's say we wanted to find the 0 of this parabola. We could start with any random point, say x equals minus 2, then find the best linear approximation of the parabola at this point. Now the 0 of this line is not the same as the 0 of the parabola, but that's okay. Let's just keep repeating this process. If we draw a few more lines like this and find their zeros, we get closer and closer to the 0 of the parabola.
With this method, you can give us any random function. As long as we can linearly approximate it, we can iterate towards the 0 of the function. Now for the fun part. What does this method look like in more than one dimensions? So now we have two variables, x and y instead of just x, and our equation is quadratic in both of them. As before, we can take everything to one side and call it z. And then if we plot this z with x and y, it ends up looking something like this.
If we set z equals 0, we'll get this circle, which is infinite number of points. This isn't surprising since there are two variables but only one equation. To get a finite number of points, we'll need another equation.
To keep things simple, let's just replicate the paraboloid we already have and shift it by a finite amount.
The second paraboloid also intersects the xy plane in a circle, and the two circles intersect at these two distinct points, which are the solution of the system of two equations.
Now, can we use our old method to find one of these solutions? Let's start by taking any random point on the plane.
First, we drop this point onto the green and yellow paraboloids corresponding to the two equations. Next, we linearly approximate the two paraboloids at their corresponding points. The approximations are planes.
The two planes intersect in a line which meets the xy plane at a single point. Now move the original point to this new point and repeat the process like before many times. As we iterate, we see that this point gets closer and closer to one of the solutions of the paraboloid. In other words, solving this linear system again and again helps us solve the original system.
So that's the Newton Raphson method. Here is the summary. For step 2, approximating with linear equations, we'll need Taylor series expansion. And for step 3, solving systems of linear equations, we need Gaussian elimination. Links to both of those methods are provided in the description. Also, a link to a blog with more examples and applications of this method. Thanks, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.